Hello friends, myself Rakesh Shavle. Today we are going to learn about network topology. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about network topology, what are the different types of topology, and what is the difference between various types of network topology. Topology is the arrangement of various computer devices or network devices are connected to each other. Types of topology. There are different types of topology. Bus topology, ring topology, star topology, mesh topology, tree topology, and hybrid topology. Bus topology. In bus topology, all the computers are connected to a single cable. This single cable is responsible for providing network facility. Every single computer is connected to main cable with the help of drop line. In bus topology, data transmission is done in one way. The computers which are connected to starting position, they will require minimum time for data transmission, and the computers which are connected to extreme end, they will require much more time in data transmission. One of the important drawback of this bus topology is that if main cable gets failed, then entire network will be collapsed. Features of bus topology. It transmits data in one direction. Every device is connected to a single cable. Advantages of bus topology. It is a cost effective. The cable required for designing a network is minimum. It is suitable for small network designing. It is easy to understand. Easy to addition of new devices in existing architecture. Disadvantages of bus topology. If main cable gets failed, then entire network will be collapsed. If network traffic is heavy, then performance of network decreases. Cable has limited length. It is slower than ring topology. Ring topology. In ring topology, every single computer is connected to its adjacent computer with the help of cables. In ring topology, data flows in circular fashion, like first device sends data to second device sends data to third device sends data to last device, and last device again connected to the first device. In ring topology, data flows in one way. One of the important drawback of this topology is that if any of the cable, intermediate cable gets failed, then rest of the network will be collapsed or entire network will be collapsed. To avoid this drawback, dual ring topology is used. In dual ring topology, every single computer is connected to another computer with the help of two cables. One cable is used for transmitting information and another cable is used for receiving the information. If one of the cable gets failed, then another link will be used either for transmitting or receiving the information. Advantages of ring topology. All data flows in one direction. It reduces the chance of packet collision. A network server is not needed to control network connectivity between each workstation. Data transfer between the workstation at higher speed. Additional workstation can be added without impacting the performance of the network. Disadvantages of ring topology. A single break in the cable can cause disturbance in entire network. This topology transmits data in one way, that is a unidirectional. Addition and removal of any node in the existing network is difficult and causes issue in the network activity. A ring network is much slower than Ethernet network. Star topology. In star topology, all the devices are connected to centralized management device like hub or switch. In this architecture, every single device is connected to centralized device like hub or switch with the help of separate cable. So that if one of the cable gets failed, then entire network will not be collapsed. So it is a beauty of this star topology, entire network will not be collapsed in case of cable failure. Features of star topology. Every node has its own dedicated connection to the hub. Hub can be act as a repeater for data flow. It can be used with twisted pair cable, optical fiber cable or coaxial cable. Advantages of star topology. Centralized management allows better monitoring of the network, easy to manage as a connection of node, and removing can be done easily. Failure of one link does not affect the rest of the network. Easy to detect failure and troubleshoot. Better performance as the signal sent by the node doesn't necessarily get transmitted to all workstations. Disadvantages of star topology. The cost of installation is high as the cable cost is increases, and it requires centralized device for connectivity, so that the cost of star topology is much more compared to other topology. It is expensive to use. If hub or switch gets failed, then entire network will be collapsed. The performance is based on hub or switch, that is depends on its capacity. Mesh topology. In mesh topology, every single device is connected to another device with the help of separate cable, so that it avoids problem of traffic congestion. Advantages. It avoids traffic problem. Robust topology, since if one node fails, other does not affect. Point-to-point connection makes it easier to detect the error. More security and privacy in connection. Disadvantages of mesh topology. More cables are required than other topology. Cost of network is high as cable quantity is much more in this topology. Installation and reconfiguration is difficult. Setup and maintenance of the topology is difficult. Throughput and transmission quantity depends on the media and capacity of switching nodes. Hybrid topology. Hybrid topology is the mix up of two or more different types of topology. Consider this diagram. In this diagram, there are three labs. In first lab, we use bus topology architecture. In second lab, we use link topology architecture. In third lab, we used star topology architecture. If these three labs are interconnected to each other, then it will form a star. Then it will be formed hybrid topology. Advantages of hybrid topology. It is reliable as error detecting and troubleshooting is easy. Scalable. The size can be easily increased or decreased. It is flexible. Disadvantages of hybrid topology. It is complex in design and it is costly.